16:05:19. Vanus Enigma video mix number 152. I'm just listening to a YouTube video from A Face Like the Sun. The video was published May 2016. The title is "The Robot Revolution is Here: Unemployment, Socialism, Religion and Sex, Tech Watch." And just thought I've been thinking this some time ago, but then so many other priorities, but now I want to say that once again, what I think, not what I wish, but what I think, like a dystopia, what's going to happen regarding Bible prophecy, a mark of the beast 666. And he mentioned the idea of basic income, because when the robots do all the work for the people need money or need help to to live. And so what I think what's going to happen, that the new world order will offer this basic income, but with the condition that you accept that mark of the beast, which is like to sell your soul to the devil. Just came out of the shower. Wait a minute, 16:05:20. And again, inspiration in the shower. Just thinking back to my short video about Simpsons, Who is God? Yahoo. And in the commandments it says you shall not make an image what is above and so on, and then I thought like thou shalt not be smarter than the video game creator. Just spoke with my mom, and we spoke about a lot of things. Maybe in the end I'll paste the end of the conversation. We just spoke a lot of about dancing and dancing styles, music, dubstep, a robot kind of break dance. I think before I'll publish this long video mix, I'll publish another short video. I just saw men dancing with dubstep, the kind of break dance style, very, very impressive. Imagine if you have a feminine style of dancing, this looks immediately like prostitution. In the end, in the street you may only wear masculine clothes, another way you are like a prostitute. And like the one hashtag too feminine, he wore feminine clothes and he got shot by accident. Hashtag too feminine. You see how so much hate in the street. I like androgynous style. That's why I'm waiting for permission to change my name of the YouTube channel into Vanessa Nima Video Mix Androgyny. At the moment, I have FTM because anyway, I want to. I have four or five reasons for mastectomy, and anyway, I may want to do the testosterone treatment. But I feel like, what I explained my mom, like all my life I was feeling like a drag queen inside a man, putting on clothes of women and performing as woman. And for that coming out video, many years now I've been hiding behind the profile pictures of different cats, mainly especially the profile picture, the white cat with written on the front, "Innocent Crypto Kitty." I like really very much this profile picture. But as when it comes to show my face, a long time I have the Twitter profile Soul Confiscator cat, and but I didn't produce any videos because I don't feel like showing my face. So now I think when it comes to really show my face, I feel like I identify like a hybrid of a robot and a drag queen, a man with wearing women's clothes, cross-dressing. And just now I got the idea, maybe I'll change change the name for the second time. I have several Twitter accounts where I like to explore different hashtags. So I some months ago I opened the Twitter account Virtual Diva V, which is one song of Don Omar. And another song I like, very similar style, Sexy Robotica. But then, at first I had the name, username, it's still Virtual Diva V. V in the end, abbreviation for Vanessa Nima or Video Mix. But now, especially thinking about this breakdance robot style, dancing music, I think maybe. Wait a minute. I first just mentioned some months ago I changed the name to Sexy Chili Kitty. Sexy Chili Kitty! After watching so many videos about Flat Earth shills and then the shill awards. Because it's like the pirate party. I made one video explaining like first they were called pirates and then it's like a pride to be called a pirate. So they founded the pirate party, copyright and intellectual property and so on, you know. And so anyway, I've got long time the same profile picture on this Twitter account, which is from my video mix number 120, if I remember well, explaining why I opened that Twitter account. And I think, yeah, this profile picture is like a robot, is one song I listened very often of video mix number 100. It's a Globot robot. Music, I like that very much, and some kind of cyberpunk, electronic dance music, EDM. So I think I'll change the name of that Twitter. Yeah, the username will still be the same, Virtual Diva V. But I think I'll change the name just a little bit because it both starts with sexy. At the moment, it's a sexy chili kitty. Sexy chili kitty! Anyway, I have some videos on my YouTube channel, short videos, Vanessa Niemann, in the sacred kitty! And I just change it from sexy chili kitty to sexy robotica. It's one song of Don Omar. Sexy robotica. V abbreviation for Vanessa Niemann or Video Mix. So I think the profile picture will still be the same because it really fits very well to the name Sexy Robotica. And especially in relation to robots. I think I want to explore more the topic of drones. Just on my video, on my YouTube channel, short videos, Vanessa Niemann. I made a short video, Maspalomas Pride. It was in Jumbo Center in the night. I was dancing there in Jumbo Center and I saw a drone flying over us, and I was very impressed. I took out the phone and made a short video. And some more hashtags in relation to robots is cyborg and cyberpunk, cyberghost. Later I'll continue. So now several days have passed. Now it's 16:05:22. Just watching more YouTube videos and just remember something about 3 years ago. I had a little problem with my health insurance. And I made the mistake to let my mother know about that. I was worried about that, and she got much more worried, and I felt much more depressed because she was worrying for me. Like always, I feel very depressed if I feel that she worries very much about me. And this was a horrible Christmas. I think it was the year 2013. And it was another thing that she said, they reacted like this because they think that you are a prostitute because you wear this and that, and this makes me feel like, like this tweet, too female. If you are too female, you get shot on the street because there's so much violence and hate on the street. You know, I'm sorry, sometimes I get a little emotional. But you know, so in the end, on the street, they are only accepted people who wear clothes like male clothes. You know? This is the hate and the discrimination, and especially MTF, male to female, who maybe like to wear female clothes. No. They are prostitute. You know, this is the hate. This is the discrimination, and so many are get murdered because maybe if I feel a little bit like a mixture between a robot. I have so many things to do on my to-do list. Mixture of robot and like a drag queen, like a male, always more or less forced to behave feminine. And anyway, in my passport it's written female, so I'm supposed to be a female person. And Okay, if there are problems with money, it's easy to work a stripper or something. And why should you stop answering? Just if you just get paid for answering the phone, why should you throw all that phone into? Anyway, I feel many years like throwing the phone out of the window into the swimming pool. But why should I do that? Because if I still get paid. Sometimes it helps me to imagine I'm really a robot without any female-male sex to all this gender headache and just focus on my to-do list without any emotion at all. Sorry, I'm getting emotional again, but sometimes I have to transform my anger into activity and. Because yeah, the anger sometimes has a positive side because it pushes you. It's like a substitute of coffee because drinking too much coffee is bad too. Then it lowers your blood sugar level and falls into that. So it's good to transform this anger energy into activity, into positive activity. And since 2012, 13, when I started with Twitter and Facebook, I've always been using profile pictures, cats. Just once I used the cat mask of Catwoman, but almost always hiding behind these profile pictures of cats. But now would like maybe to show my face sometimes in front of the camera, although I still like to create videos like this, but I identify, still I like to continue using these profile pictures, but I've got another Twitter account, which is this Sexy Robotica, and maybe I just the other day I spoke with my mom and I told her, yeah, I went dancing over there in this Pride parade. And like identify like a mixture between a robot and drag queen, men cross-dressing as woman. But I really like that name, Sexy Robotica, one title of the new. The song of Don Omar and username is Virtual Diva. It's almost the same style of music of Don Omar. And maybe I'll be more active on that Twitter account, although I have connected my Twitter account, a Naughty Katzilla, Innocent Crypto Kitty, with my YouTube channel short videos, Vanessa Lima, and it copies automatically if I like a video. And maybe I write comments on that Twitter account, Sexy Robotica. And I use this a little like a filter to then just copy the most important tweets to my main Twitter account, Vanessa Lima. And yeah, I like to explore these different hashtags on these different Twitter accounts. One day later, 16:05:23. Before I continue talking, I just want to read a few comments I wrote on YouTube watching many videos about FTM, and there is one FTM who showed his kitty, and it was so nice. I wrote, not sure who is more perfect, your kitty or you? Question mark. Yeah, another one. He was complaining about it will take so long. I wrote, I, me too. I think I'll take it will take an eternity because I'm between these two countries, Spain and Germany, and I don't have insurance in Germany, just emergency. And another video, I wrote a comment, I feel very similar. It's about a female FTM. And anyway, in the about section of my main YouTube channel, I wrote, awaiting for permission to include the word androgyny in the title of my YouTube channel. And concerning about the topic of getting a misgendered, I don't care if people say he or she, just use my preferred name. And I will not change my legal name anyway. I try to avoid using that. I don't trust this corrupt legal system. I'm, and another comment, I'm more than 2 times 18 years old. At this age, I don't want to worry anymore about if I get permission for testosterone or not. I have done so many things on my own. Yeah, I would really like to start soon because my whole life I was, and still I'm afraid to go get pregnant by any accident. And at the moment, long time, more than 20 years, I've been taking the pill. I'm really, really, really tired of taking the pill. Anyway, it lowers your testosterone level. And so I told myself about almost 1 month ago to stop it. And now I'm just, now in these days, my period should come. I should be wearing always the Pampers because it could start any day. And anyway, I'm afraid, I told you, and that's why I really would like to start soon, just because of the fear of getting pregnant by accident. Anyway, I don't have sexual relationships, but anyway, you never, shit happens, you know. And I told you before in videos before, my first reason for testosterone is because I have these very bad consequences of this anorexia which I had at the age of 12. And the consequence, I repeat, is that I have only bones and skin on my hands and feet because no fat cells came there. Even if I win weight, I have still bad circulation in my hands and feet, and this has the consequence that I have often chronic inflammation of the throat, and I feel always very bad because of this always cold hand and feet. Although maybe I sweat under my arms, under my boobs, and I have to change the clothes because it feels cold and wet because of the cold sweat. But anyway, still always cold hands and feet. And I know if testosterone makes even the hands and feet grow, and it makes a better blood circulation. That's actually my first priority. I don't care if I look this or that. Anyway, I'm always alone at home. I don't quite care really. I just care what God thinks of me, and to justify my actions and decisions. Anyway, I would prefer to be a robot, to just do what I have to do and not sin, and Jesus have to die for my sins. I don't want to sin. I just want to do what I have to do, and that's it. Sorry, sometimes I get a little emotional. It's a sign that I'm not yet a robot, that I'm still a human, that I have human feelings. Right now I'm listening to several videos of the YouTube channel BioBalance Healthcast, written together, and I appreciate them, especially because they put their license in Creative Commons, and they have really good knowledge. They have studied, I think they have a title of doctor, I don't care about that, but they even discuss, you know, they treat their patients, and they speak very openly about these topics. They say, I'm afraid to do this because the state government health regulations could shut down their service. So it's really interesting because it's always the borderline. What do we have permission to do because of the laws of the state? And remember that coffee was illegal some 100 years ago, and the state wants to have control about these major drugs. And just think of the differences between just in United States of America. Different states have the different laws about the weed, marijuana. By the way, some days ago I was more or less raped by Windows 10 to upgrade. It automatically started. Just wanted to go to sleep, and then it said upgrading, don't close the window. But just a few days I tried, and in the end I had a lot of problems. The toolbar in the bottom, the icons disappeared, and in the end it got very, very slowly to the point that I didn't get in anymore. So I'm just using my small substitute PC, laptop, just Linux, and I still haven't figured out exactly when I just suspend, and then the internet connection, it's like, seems I always have to go to suspend and then to re-establish the internet connection. I'm not used to work with Linux, but on the next laptop, I think I want to avoid Windows and try to see if I can edit my videos. Especially it's about editing. But I think now some programs have been developed to work with Linux. Anyway, the security, it's much better. Maybe in the future, much more women, especially older women like me, over 40, feel some kind of forced or motivated to do that testosterone treatment because the life on the street, especially with many immigrants coming from Muslim countries, and often they don't respect women. For example, one case, one female police officer came and they didn't respect her at all. So it seems like, and anyway, if you look too female, anyway, which kind of sex you're born, you get shot. Like in that tweet, it's written, you know? It's so much hate on the streets. You look female, you are a prostitute. So you have everybody seems to. You understand what I mean? I'm just talking about my feelings, my motivations to start this testosterone treatment, and in case and in I feel like having to justify myself, especially because of the health insurance, the interview with a psychologist and endocrinologist, to explain why I want to start the testosterone treatment. Actually, I really want to care much, much, much more what God thinks about to justify the actions in front of God, although sometimes people doubt even of the existence of God, and all these laws which are written in Leviticus, Old Testament, that the society has the right to stone women to death if they are pregnant, if there's no husband around. Sorry, I'm exaggerating a little, but it's like I get sometimes emotional. I just had a conversation with my mother, and about she said something like, "Oh, you should use more your." She didn't say exactly dancing. She was often she said something, "Oh, you should do self-defense course or something." And lately, I've been watching some videos about breakdance, dubstep style. Maybe I'll copy one video. I really like that. I've got it on my to-do list. I've got so much on my to-do list. Incredible. But right now, I feel like talking. And what I actually wanted to say is that I wrote hashtag breakdance in one of my Twitter accounts, the Sexy Robotica, and the style of music like dubstep or chill step. Actually, I prefer it's like a mixture of chill out and dubstep. And I told her Maybe do some break dance, and it's you can even do this maybe on the street, hashtag street dance, without in German I said ohne als Prostituierte abgestempelt zu werden, without getting judged as prostitute, because this is too often a little bit the reason, like I feel like strange going, I'm always on my own, and often feel like strange people look at me. Ah, oh, this is what's the matter with her? She's alone. She seems like a prostitute. So I often I feel like in the church, all the couples go to the church, and I feel like oh, and they look at me. So many years I don't do anything. I just hide at home, because especially since the death of my father, anything you do is wrong. Even if you don't do something on the computer and internet, you break this copyright, the intellectual property, which inhabits in a innovation, a freedom of expression. You just lie in your bed and die. That's what you have to do. You don't. You anything you do, it can be wrong. Okay, something else. I told my mom just the word androgyny. Many people don't know, even I admit I didn't know that word, and I was really positively surprised. It's, unisex is just for the clothes or for the bathrooms, but this is like it's a balance between male and female. God said he created the humans male and female. So it means God created the humans in the image of God. So we can guess that God is half male and female, that God is an androgynous. And so I think it's Lucifer. But sometimes I think like, oh, wait a minute. Just thinking of one video, Rod Stewart. Sorry, Rod Stewart. Scuba, Rod Scuba. Videos, Flat Earth, especially proving the globe, or something like this. And the angels before the age of Noah. Oh, maybe raped the women, and giants, the result were giants of these fallen angels. So the consequence, he says that God sent the big flood with Noah. So it seems like angels were some kind of male. A male masculine, not really androgynous. And one more rhyme comes to my mind, which is father's, no, wait a minute, mother's baby, father's maybe. was one video of, what's the name of that YouTube channel? Sabbatical something. But it's Creative Commons. I remember very well because I put the filter. If I remember well, it was I put in androgyny and Bible, if I remember well, and then the filter of Creative Commons, and I think I came to that video this way. Anyway, if you put in the filter Bitcoin and Flat Earth, most videos are, or my videos, Creative Commons. Permission to remix 16:05:25. So a few days have passed since I made the last recording. I'm not sure if I maybe start a new video. I just randomly talk about different topics which come to my mind. Yesterday again, I had a little psychological crisis. I just okay. Normally, I don't like to go out late in the day when I prefer to go out in the morning or in the midday, but I had things to do and I was feeling like, oh. So just before I went out, I had a little drink with alcohol. And usually, often when I have drunk a little, the tears are more easily to go to start crying or to feel like I want to cry. And anyway, who knows the exact answer? What is the sense of life? Sometimes it feels really like, oh, always running behind the money. It's so. But today is another day. It was yesterday, I repeat. And today, maybe I should mention first that just now I started to watch one video. Anyway, I watch many videos. I'm living on my own. So, and anyway, my both TVs are broken and I don't want to buy a new one. And this is I just put on in the YouTube a filter trans, the word TRANS and Creative Commons, I think I put. This is my favorite filter. Yes, it's Creative Commons. And as I said before, sometimes I feel so, oh, very little motivation. What is the sense in life? People in general need a stronger motivation to know why they are living, not just to fucking run behind the money and buy things you don't need and which get broken immediately. And anyway, they produce the products, so they have a very limited life expectant so that the consumerism is accelerated and they have to buy immediately new and run behind the money and mind fuck. So watching this video now, I think I really long time before, honestly, I have very much sympathy, or actually I identify much like MTF rather than FTM, because I feel like having like a male inside and just always putting on this female facade. So I think anyway, I have decided always I didn't doubt to change my legal name. Anyway, I don't trust the legal system. And anyway, this is very much work to change so many documents. I really don't want to change my legal female name, but I think it's like for me a motivation to defend these people who suffer from discrimination. It gives me motivation, like for life. It's like a task, like something, a theme, which gives sense to my life. It's like an, especially MTF, male to female from black community, they suffer very much discrimination. And anyway, since I studied, especially from the YouTube channel Truth Unveiled 777, about this hashtag Synagogue of Satan and who are the real Jews, now I have suddenly much more sympathy for the black community, especially because they suffer so much discrimination. And I really like to, I feel like I really like to help, especially the people who suffer discrimination. And if people think of me, of the same group, although it's completely different, it's very similar, like the cosmology, the hashtag Let's Talk FE Flat Earth. Do you really know what you believe about your belief system about cosmology? You think then maybe, okay, maybe I put on female clothes. You think maybe, I'm a person who is born a male, who is trying to put on clothes female. But in reality, I was born female. Look at my fingers. Compare, anyway, maybe I should do separate videos comparing the index finger, the length of the index finger compared with the ring finger. Watch that video of Michelle Obama. Wait a minute, there are two YouTube channels. I just read the title. Yeah, at the moment I've got it on the top of my Twitter account. Vanusending my video mix. I liked video from Pockets of Future. Over 95% chance Michelle Obama and Jennifer Aniston born men. Yeah, especially this topic comparing the length of the index finger with the ring finger. So it's very obvious that the ring finger of Michelle Obama is longer than the index finger. And on my both hands, I prefer to turn the fingers this way, that you look in the inner palm of the hands, because the nails, the side of the nails can, they can mislead the perception of the length of the fingers. So on my hands, when I look from inside, both my index fingers are longer than my ring fingers. So actually, if I think of photos for identification, I think if people show the teeth, like some kind of smiling, and show the, for example, of the right hand, and put it there near the cheek or under the, not just like Illuminati covering one ear, one eye, no, just a little lower. This would give much more information about the identity. If you make photo for passport, identification, ID card. Okay, maybe it's better I keep this in the same video because this is almost TMI, too much information. How I identify. Anyway, I said imagine being a robot, so I just do what I have to do and just suppress all the emotions, especially the negative emotions. But about male and female, I think I said it before, I really don't feel like a baby producing machine, which is the female body is designed to produce babies. Wait a minute, just read what I... Genesis 1:28, King James Version, KJV. And God blessed them, and God said unto them, be fruitful and multiply and replenish the earth. Sometimes I feel like a little under mind control of Illuminati, because all the time, even before, if I remember well, even before I was 12 years older, before I fell into this, that anorexia, very dangerous. When I heard babies screaming, I thought, oh, what's the sense of coming to Earth and scream and all these problems I had? I remember having these feelings really very, very early in my childhood. And what I wanted to say about the female body, what is it good for? Producing babies, machine, and the advantage you can work as prostitute. Because with you have run behind the money, and if there is, are no not the state laws which give some rights to the women to have a court law, and when there's a divorce, then you are. But anyway, I don't want to have as little as possible to have to do with. Anyway, my philosophy is Christian anarchism, and everything. Everything would be better if everything would be regulated by the state, like in communism. Fuck off. Sorry, I'm being sarcastic. What I wanted to say, my attitude at the moment, I'm really very, 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 very tired to be regarded as like a prostitute. Okay, I have some kind of attitude. You want to have to, you want to come into my apartment, you want to have to do something with me, buy my fucking apartment. Sorry, I'm getting emotional again. Sorry, I want to repress all my feelings, all my fucking feelings.
By the way, at the moment, I'm at 69,000 euros. That's not very much. You can buy my apartment here in Gran Canaria.
That's my voice. And I promise you, when I take testosterone, my voice will not go down. It will go up because I am innocent good to kitty. Yeah, that's true. Maybe it's better I put that in, that in the end of the video. Anyway, often did you observe this? When there is some TMI, too much information, it's often in the end of the videos. Okay, I admit I'm getting drunk again. But you know, it's... these female fucking hormones. Slowly I'm going to kill myself. If I don't do a little bit something for my... I feel like I have to justify myself. First of all, I care much more what God thinks about me than any psychologist where I have to ask for permission, or any people out there. Anyway, I'm always on my own here. I'm very accustomed to be alone. I have done so many things on my own. I have traveled whole Europe, over the sea, Gran Canaria, España, in the fucking ship, get seasick 3 days, sleeping on the floor, and all this. I've done, and sleeping on the motorway on my own. I've done so many things on my own. I can... What I wanted to say that I think for me it's better. Anyway, I want to keep the legal name to present myself more female, because anyway I feel more attracted to men than I don't feel lesbian at all. But I repeat, I really don't feel like a baby producing machine. Okay, let's correct men or a male females. What else? Did I want to say that this topic of psychologist, especially yesterday, I felt again very depressive. And but okay, I went several times in my life to a psychologist, but most of the times it was more or less like pushed off my parents, off especially my mother. Just one time I only just one went on my own, but they prescribed me something which made me feel much more like a zombie, and always very tired. And so long time I didn't go, although I might have gone, but I didn't have the feeling that they could help me. Just now I have to go, because I know what can help me, but I have to go first to have their permission to buy a testosterone. Okay, they might help me to buy that. This is the advantage, but I feel like I have to justify now all my decisions, my feelings, and I feel like it will be more convincing if I start the therapy on my own, because they often start slowly with a cream, although it is more expensive than the injection. But just after this little first step, the next steps will seem more convincing if you talk with a psychologist. So I wonder if you buy illegally, will they throw you into prison in comparison to the corruption of Panama Papers? Is this very, very, very much illegal? so much corruption in the world. It's incredible. I feel so pissed off of this injustice, legal system, so many things which are wrong. And I feel very impotent that I really can change something. But for some reason, it seems that I have been born, and it might be a sin, un pecado, if you suicide. So might be better to try your best to do something. But anyway, anything you do can be wrong, so it will be worse. So I don't know if it's good to try to do something or start just stay at home and wait till you die. Just remember now when I was a little baby, I was engendered in Switzerland, born in Germany, but engendered in Switzerland. So the first months or year we lived in Switzerland, and I always heard my parents speaking German and the children speaking Schweizerdeutsch, and I was very confused, and my mother told me that she observed me how to pronounce, how to practicing the spelling of the words, because I didn't want to make a mistake. It starts very early, being afraid of making any mistake. Anyway, everywhere you can make a mistake, so better shut up and do nothing. It's a little exaggerated, but there are many possibilities to do something wrong, and very few options to do something right. So why this headache of life? What are you supposed to do? The free will is like un castigo. Sorry, Spanish. It's like a burden you have. You have to figure out what is right, what is wrong. And if you take too much time to take this decision, that's wrong too. I just want to say that the feeling of wanting to cry is often just without a real reason. It comes often after drinking, maybe a little too much, or sometimes just it's enough, only one little beer, and you feel like it's like a substitute of orgasm, a little, a kind of. Anyway, for many women it's very difficult to reach the orgasm. I often feel like, oh, I just watch the watch. I have a look at the watch. How long do I have to take effort till I reach this fucking orgasm? And then I often say, when can I break my new record of reaching this fucking orgasm? Sorry, using forward. But it's the truth, you know. So, what I want to say, the desire, this feeling of crying is just like a little addiction. It's like a little addiction, because it feels like this substitute for an orgasm, you know? And now I'm watching many videos about FTM. I never have ever taken any artificial testosterone till now, so I don't know the effect on my body. But I have seen many videos now of people, FTM, who tell that their desire or their feeling of crying has diminished very much after starting testosterone. And just now I'm thinking, sometimes I heard, yeah, it is illegal to buy a testosterone on your own. So what are they going to do? They are going, they want to throw me into the prison. This would be hurt me less than if they would confiscate any of my this is one of the reasons why I feel like don't want to admit that I have any psychological problem, because if they as soon as they know that you have a little psychological problem, they take advantage of you, and then they say, you are not countable. Then they will take Vormund in Germany to confiscate your property. Then I get very aggressive. So take the right. You are not countable to defend your rights. So they take advantage of you. Wait a minute. Sorry, getting emotional again. What I wanted to say, I rather prefer to have an experience to see the prison from inside than to have. Just for a little time, I want to say, because it seems like here in Gran Canaria they built a new prison, even with a piscina, with a swimming pool. It's like, you have like a paid hotel and with the food and. But if they confiscate property, this is another. This is something very different, because who knows how long you have to provide for your life when you're older? You don't have any reserves. Anyway, I said often enough. I don't trust this corrupt legal system. My philosophy is a Christian anarchism. And in relation to the topic of prostitution, I want to mention one topic, the treatment of Antarctica, that it cannot be used for any corporations. As you know, Admiral Byrd made several excursions, and they all the nations decided that this region will be protected by the states. There are many mineral resources, and there wouldn't be any necessity for people starving from hunger in the world. So all this running, chasing money, running after the money is a really unnecessary suffering of humanity. Men and women equal, but very often women are suffering much more. Many young women, girls, are sold for money to serve, especially in Muslim countries. It's incredible, so the suffering for this. the problem of money and it's the Satanism we are suffering from. Bohemian Grove, Baphomet, figure of mixture of male and female. As I said before, I put the YouTube filter, Creative Commons, the word trans. And right now I'm watching Video Panama, Personas Trans en Español. The name of the YouTube channel is Comisión Interamericana de Derechos Humanos. By the way, I have another YouTube channel, Bueno Cinema Español. And just what I wanted to say, I feel like a motivation for my life, a kind of sense of life, like to be like a lawyer for the people MTF. Because who more than me, a real person who has been born female, to defend those people who like to put on female clothes or who identify female but have been born male. And one more thing, you know, I have many Twitter accounts. The Twitter account I'm most active on is the name Innocent Crypto Kitty, because I really think sometimes really the most important thing in life is to be innocent, not just regarding to people but in front of God, because Jesus Christ came to free us of the sins, but I don't want him to die for our sins. I want to be without sin myself. Okay, I believe in what he did and I put my hope on him, but him or her or okay, it seems he was really born male, but he always is depicted in with long hair and white skin. This is very doubtable if he had really white skin. At least he was, I think, a little much more brown than my white color of the cat I use as profile picture. And what did I say? The clothes, the hair, long hair. You understand what I mean, okay? Listening more to that video about Derechos Humanos Español. I said before, I have bills to pay. I feel I feel much more, if I should admit, like an expensive, more than expensive, you can't permit expensive prostitute than a baby producing machine. Anyway, it's illegal to sell human beings. This would be really, really, really you imagine this happens, really. Mothers who give birth and sell their babies. This is really and then imagine, first it's illegal, and second the pain inside of that person of feeling I have sold my baby. Impossible. But we have to run behind the money. This is the reality. So just wanted to say I feel rather identify with a very expensive prostitute than a baby producing machine. And anyway, if I would try, Okay, I'm very decided to do the testosterone treatment, and because of cancer risk, especially to remove my breast mastectomy. Anyway, if I would try to pretend to be male, but I will never, 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 ever be 100% male. I would never be able to give sperm and impregnate a woman. So why try to pretend something I would never be able to be? I feel rather like my little bit sense of life is to defend MTF, male to female people, like imagine God having to judge the humans. He or she doesn't, androgyny, God doesn't know how it feels to be judged, so he sent his son Jesus Christ to feel how it is like to feel, to be a human being, and this way, like to feel like in the skin, in the shoes of a male, you can understand much more better if you are going to try to defend this group of people. You understand?